By request of the meeting organizer, this meeting is being recorded.
Thursday morning tea.
Morning.
Welcome
Hi,
back,
everyone.
Ken. Thank you. This is Ken Joyce, back from the House of Mercy. And hey, who's on the line with us today?
Julie.
Julie. Hi, Julie.
Hi, Ken. Hi, Steve.
What's going on?
I'm just drinking coffee, listening to you all be silly.
Yeah, it has been kind of a silly morning.
It has.
Yeah, well, we're all having our comfortable cup of tea or coffee.
I got the water.
Yeah. Back on the wagon. I'm drinking the water.
Sorry, I'm rubbing up against your leg.
Okay. Really growing closer here.
Yeah.
St. Louis. So... welcome, everyone, and today we're kind of giving a preview to Mercy Day, which is coming up September 24th.
It absolutely is.
Which is an exciting time where we all celebrate together the beginning of our ministry at the house on Bagot Street. Ken.
Yes.
You're our expert. Why Mercy Day? What?
Well, Mercy Day celebrates, and they celebrate all over the world. Mercy Day is celebrated because that is the day that the house on Bagot Street first opened.
Okay.
The name came from the fact that September 24th is also the feast day of Our Lady of Mercy.
Okay, so it's a Catholic feast day.
It is.
Yeah.
Yep. And interestingly, little sidebar, it was not named by Catherine. It was named by Anne Marie Doyle.
Okay.
And Catherine agreed to the name, but that was the name that Anne Marie.
And you were telling us on the day of the celebration, the opening of the house,
yeah,
Catherine wasn't even there.
She wasn't there. She was taking care of a sick relative, and so it was truly Anne Marie Doyle who opened the House of Mercy.
So Catherine missed the first Mercy Day.
Yeah.
And just saying that.
The party went on.
It's like they had a party and she didn't even show up.
Right, that's right. You know, when she opened up the house, it makes me think, and when you see the image there, that it was a lot of things all at once. It was an orphanage. It was a refuge, you know, a night refuge for folks. It was an employment bureau. They tried to teach folks skills so that they could be employable, kind of a rehab center. It was also a shelter, so a school. And eventually, you know, the children were taught, you know, Catholic prayers and that discipline, and eventually became a convent too. But it was a lot of things all at once, which I think is huge for us to know that.
Well, in a way, even though we focus on healthcare here at Mercy, we really are a lot of things for a lot of people in the communities we serve. I mean, all of those things you described, I think we all do that in some way, shape, or form.
Mm-hmm. I think it's also important that what you had said earlier, Steve, regarding, you know, it demonstrates the fact that Catherine wasn't there but entrusted Anne Marie Doyle to open the house on September 24th shows us that, like you said, we don't necessarily have to be, we can delegate and trust, and we don't have to be present in order for the ministry to be moving forward.
Well, that's why the mission team in St. Louis is not going to be here on Mercy Day. We're actually
we're taking the day off.
We're taking the day off.
We're going to fish, I think. Don't know what to say to that.
Well, we have great images there of ways that people can celebrate Mercy Day. You know, this we're encouraging people all over the ministry with their departments and their teams to be creative and to celebrate this important day in our history and in our culture. And so we have some great images there. You can't go wrong with cake and cookies. So that's, I think, a must. And look how one team, I don't know what hospital that is, but they had, you know, kind of a formal tea set and flowers.
That was just a department. That was the radiology or imaging department in Springfield.
Here in Springfield, wasn't it?
Get out their finest silver on Mercy Day. So if you're a leader or even if you're a coworker, we encourage you to volunteer to decorate for Mercy Day for your department. Just make it a fun and festive day for sure.
Yep, that's right. And we have materials for folks to celebrate. So the theme this year is unique and united. And we've been talking about the ways that the House of Mercy was unique and the variety of ways that ministry was done, but it was also a way that Catherine welcomed, the Sisters of Mercy welcomed the neighbor, I mean welcomed people from all walks of life, and we do that every day in the work that we do, in the ministry that we do. We come across coworkers, patients, family members who are from, you know, have different family dynamics, different family cultures, speak different languages, have different religious beliefs, different ethnic backgrounds. So we're all unique, but we're united as we serve together in the name of God. And so that's the theme. And just to share with you all a little bit about the activity that we have with this. I know, Steve, you and Ken were asking me about this yesterday.
Right, and the last couple of years we've done this on Mercy Day, and one of the things that Ken and I kind of find we're not really artistic kind of people, right. But and we're not really fun either, but that a lot of our coworkers really enjoy these activities that we put out there.
Yeah.
So I really encourage people to put those out there for their coworkers and for their teams. But you're going to tell us about this year's activity.
Yes, in the past we've done like a crossword puzzle, a word search, but this year we're doing something a little bit different in thinking about a stained glass window and how it has many different pieces and colors, but it's so unique but yet united to make a beautiful piece of art. And so we've provided an activity and it's called a mandala. And so a mandala means a circle.
Mandala?
No.
Oh.
It's a spiritual tool called mandala. And I also have another example. So you see one there on the slide. That's the one that we're providing for our coworkers. But also, can you kind of see? I can't see, but there's another example of a mandala. You can Google an image. And actually, these are so popular now that Barnes & Noble sells coloring books full of mandalas.
Oh.
Let me tell you a little bit about why we chose this. So it's really a spiritual discipline tool. It's a way to focus. It's a way to quiet yourself. It's a way to spend time with God. Of course, the circle meaning it never ends, so the love of God never ends. So you see the mandala that we've provided for coworkers this year also has another spiritual tool within it called a labyrinth. Now, a labyrinth is different than a maze. A maze, when you do those, you know, you get lost or you have to go back, you come to a dead end. But a labyrinth is a continuing journey to the center. So it has a starting point and you make your way in. So you could use a pencil because it's so small on our mandala, and you would make your way into the middle, and then you would again journey on the way out. You would go out the same way you come in, and the whole idea is to be quiet and to focus. And there are some questions I think that people can reflect on in relation to this mandala as they're having conversation. So they might think about ways that they're unique. So as they start in with the labyrinth or begin coloring the mandala, to think about what are the unique gifts that I bring to Mercy, and then make their way into the middle where the cross is, the Mercy cross there, and to spend some time listening for maybe God's voice, or just to be quiet and to focus on those unique gifts that we each bring to Mercy. And then as you journey back out with that labyrinth, to think about ways that we are united and how we serve together. So it's really meant to be this beautiful spiritual tool. And I know there are some people that think, oh gosh, coloring, how ridiculous. But yet, it really can be prayerful. It's a way that the team can celebrate and have conversation, but it also can be used maybe if you're having a tough day, you've had a tough patient, a tough phone call, interaction with a coworker that didn't go well, and you might have some anxiety or anger. Rather, spend some time coloring in a mandala. It really is just to be able to focus and have some there. There's Steve's.
So, Julie, I started my mandala this morning.
Yes, look at
I am one of those people who is not a very good colorer. As you can see, as we get to the brown, I really start falling out of the line. So then I got angry, and then I had to go do another mandala.
I calm my nerves.
If you don't like that one, find another image, I think. But I do want to let people know that one of our own Vice President of Mission, Joel James in Joplin, he drew that mandala for us with the labyrinth, you know, freehand. So his artistic ability, we have the ability to do that. So it is just a tool. It's not just a tool. It is a spiritual discipline tool for people to use.
And we appreciate the team that put together all of the Mercy Day materials, folks in marketing and communication and in mission.
Absolutely.
This is just a real time of celebration. Mercy Day is next week. Hopefully folks in their clinics, their departments, or even who are working at home will take some time to celebrate Mercy Day.
Absolutely.
As Catherine says, it is God's will that everyone called to his service should be happy. So let's just let this time be a time of happiness and celebrating that ministry that started back in 1827 on September 24th. And what a blessed feast day it is for all of us. For those watching today, we offer these reflection questions just to think a little bit today about what does Mercy Day mean to me, and what does it mean for the members of my team to be unique and united? So
it's always me, isn't it?
Yeah, that was not a slip. That was just me being all about me.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
So I think it's important too for people to be able to feel, particularly during Mercy Day, that direct connection that we have going all the way back to the House of Mercy. And the work that's being done, I can tell you when I'm there, the most meaningful thing that I have the honor of doing is when poor and homeless people come knock on the door, and they do daily, and they are in need of a sandwich or a cup of tea, and to be able to serve them just as Catherine would have. And if you take that and look at today's world and what we each are doing here in the ministry, we have those opportunities to serve each other every day. And I think we sometimes get so clouded with our own work and our own busyness that we forget that people are being put in our paths every day for us to be able to serve. So, you know, kind of maybe open your eyes a bit and put down the phone and look around at who is in need of your particular gifts.
I want to encourage everyone to continue joining us on Facebook, sharing this calendar event on Outlook with your friends at Mercy, and to join the Facebook group so you can continue enjoying the extra resources and materials we put out there. And yes, we're just so excited about Mercy Day.
Hey!
Yay!
Yay. Don't you wish that? Instead of saying a comfortable cup of tea, don't you wish you would have said something like a comfortable glass of wine?
Yeah.
So, and we would celebrate that.
Nope.
No
tea, folks.
No.
Anyway, well, as Catherine says, resolve to be good today.
But better tomorrow.
Have a good day, everyone.
Have a great day, everybody.